Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today I'm gonna show you how to download long-term climatic data from Power Data Access Viewer data app. This data app is crucial to download different parameters of weather and climate. Let's get started. The first step that we are going to do is open your internet browser and on search bar type Power Data Access Viewer. Power Access Data Viewer, search it. From this option, select Data Access Viewer, NASA Power. As you know, power means the prediction of world energy source. This is an abbreviation. P stands for prediction of world energy resource. So click here. Then we have the interface. Welcome to the Power Data Access Viewer. Here there is different description. There is the lat long, the spatial resolution, and different explanations are available here. Scroll down and click on access data. I will come back about the enhanced data access viewer, but for the time being I'm not interested for this session. So this is the general interface. I would like to introduce the general interface. This is a base map. So there is zoom in and zoom out. Here there is a location of your specific destination or location. Here we have different options. This is an instrument or icon that helps to download single point in a certain geographic area. For instance, if you are living in South America or in Europe or North America or Africa, click at a certain XY coordinate and you can easily access the climate data. This is the Power Regional Data Access. You can create a polygon in a certain geographic area and you can access the different parameters of climate data. If you are attentive to download climatic data at a global scale, you can use this icon, click, and simply you can download. Here there is different layers, the data layer that is available on this data hub. This is a power report. This site is very crucial and fundamental to generate different reports in the form of HTML file. There is a summary report of your data. So the main concern is how to download climatic data. To do so, first of all, search your area of interest. For instance, my area of interest is Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, and type on search bar as Addis Ababa, then click or search. Automatically the base map goes to the area of interest. This is Addis Ababa, which is located in Ethiopia. If someone is interested to download the climatic data of a certain point, we use this icon, Power Single Point. Click here. The Power Single Point have different options. The first one is choose user community, the type of data that you are interested to download. So here there is renewable energy, sustainable building, and agroclimatology. Select renewable energy. This is a temporal average. I am attentive or in lack of to download climatic data on monthly and annual basis. Select this. So here you can put the latitude and longitudinal position of an area. For instance, you can put this, or if you are recognize your area of interest, simply you can click this icon and go to your area of interest and click that. Automatically generates the XY coordinates of this point. So this point is actually found 9.0 309 latitude north of the equator and 38.7914 east of the Greenwich meridian. So I have set the criteria. The other is the starting date. Is the data is available from 1981 up to 2021. So I need all the data. Here is the output output file format. If someone wants to enjoy JSON file format or net CDF file format or CSV, you can select based on your preference. I need to download the climate data in terms of CSV or Excel file format. The final is the selection parameters. Here there are different parameters. I'm interested to download temperature data, so click on here. We have different option: temperature at 2 meter, dew of frost point at 2 meter, wet bulb temperature at 2 meter. So I need the maximum and minimum temperature, and the other parameter is humidity or precipitation. I need to download rainfall data. So stretch this and click the average precipitation average. So click this. Finally, you can submit. Here there is on process. After a while, we'll gain the product. This is the final output. So now we can easily download by clicking on CSV. Click here. I have the Excel sheet. Let me open it and let me have a look. This is that here there is a maximum temperature, minimum temperature, and here is a precipitation. I have selected 3 parameters: the minimum, the maximum, and then the rainfall. So as far as the maximum temperature is concerned, I have from 1981 from January to December, and we have annual average maximum temperature, annual average minimum temperature, and precipitation as well. So this is the data that I have downloaded for a certain single point. But if we are attentive to download at a global scale, you can click here. If someone is interested to download a certain region, you can create a polygon. Let me show you. For instance, click a region, click here. So the power regional data access is available. So to create or to download the climate data at a regional level, click this. All the parameters are similar that I have followed earlier. So click this extent, then select your area of interest by making certain rectangle. So this is the X minimum, the X maximum, Y minimum, and Y maximum. So this is the latitude and longitudinal position. And finally, you can submit and you can easily download the data. This is all about today's session. If you have any question, let me know.